Welcome to USA Breaking News Today. Please subscribe and click notification box to get all breaking news alert.
Breaking news today. Syria missile attack. Russia blames Israel for strike on airbase. Russia has blamed Israel for the missile attack on a Syrian airbase that reportedly killed at least 12 people. Moscow claimed this morning that two Israeli fighter jets had launched the attack on the T-4 base. The Russian Defense Ministry said the F-15 planes had carried out the strikes from Lebanese airspace. And it claimed Syrian air defense systems had shot down 5 of 8 missiles fired. The Israeli military have made no comment on the claims. Syrian state TV said on Monday the U.S. was suspected of striking the base, something Washington denied. It came hours after Donald Trump warned of a big price to pay as aid groups said dozens of people were killed by poison gas in a rebel-held town. Israel has previously accused Damascus of allowing Iran to set up a complex at the base to supply arms to its ally, Lebanon's Shiite Hezbollah. Today's statements are unusual for Russia, which has generally been reticent about Israeli strikes in Syria even as it tries to shore up President Bashar al-Assad's rule. Russia and Israel set up a hotline in 2015 to prevent accidental clashes between their forces in Syria, and diplomatic sources on both sides say Moscow is willing to turn a blind eye to Israeli actions as long as they do not destabilize Damascus. Israel rarely acknowledges strikes in Syria but has said that, as a matter of policy, they aim to thwart the entrenchment of Iranian forces or arms transfers to Hezbollah. The United States launched a cruise missile strike on a Syrian air base a year ago, after dozens of civilians died in a gas attack in an opposition town in northwest Syria. The Syrian state has denied that government forces launched any chemical attack. Russia, Assad's most powerful ally, has called the reports fake. In the UK, Theresa May has been urged to expand Britain's military operations in the region, with Defence Minister Tobias Elwood warning the country cannot keep turning a blind eye to the horrors of the conflict. Foreign Secretary Boris Johnson said in February that Britain should consider joining military action against Assad's regime if there is fresh incontrovertible evidence he has used chemical weapons against his own people. David Cameron lost a historic Commons vote in 2013 over launching airstrikes on the Assad regime to deter its use of chemical weapons, damaging his credibility. There is no legal requirement on the government to seek parliamentary approval before ordering military action, but it has become convention to consult MPs, except in the event of an emergency. Thanks for watch. Please share, like, comment this video and subscribe channel for latest news.